Hi Virgo, this is House of Virgo doing your next 24 hours love reading for Virgo Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. If you want to get a personal reading from me, there's a link below this video in the description box. Please do like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And if you're new, welcome. Okay, you can also follow me on Instagram at House of Virgo. You can also check out my other YouTube tarot channel called Moon Pie Tarot. If you know who that is, yes, this is me. All right, Virgo, so we're going to take a look at the past energy here with someone that you may have been involved with. Okay, the Hermit, Page of Swords, and Knight of Swords. Present energy, Temperance. So Virgo, Sagittarius, Four of Swords, Ten of Swords, a lot of swords here. Future, death. Queen of Wands. And more sword energy. Wow. And I have to tell you, I mean, sword energy is tough to deal with, okay? It really is. I mean, the only good sword card is seriously the Ace of Swords. The rest is, I mean, the Four of Swords is good because there's a sense of rest and peace. Okay. I mean, they're not all bad, but it's just, there's a lot of cerebral energy here and there's no cup energy, which tells me that even though this is a love reading, there's some other stuff showing up here. So let's start with the past, the Hermit. There's an energy of like going within. Somebody just kind of withdraw. You may be dealing with someone who withdraws a lot. Not intentional neglect. It's just that this person has a tendency to go into quiet, to gain, to process thoughts, feelings. They're, you know, tangible things, where they are, where they've been, the journey they've been on. It's kind of like the Hermit goes to the top of a mountain. And he just wants to be alone for a little while. So you may have dealt with that kind of energy or just felt like the relationship was in this position of like a timeout, okay? Your person, whomever they are, the Page of Swords, we're on a quest for, I feel they were looking for something. You know, Page is all about communication, but there's a strong curiosity. Maybe some things were said, some gossip, prying eyes, seeking the truth, this person. Okay, and maybe they brought you some truth or came to you that they were trying to have some kind of a lifestyle change that they were ready to make, but it was swift. And I feel like it was well thought out, but it was spoken too quickly. Whatever they were saying or whatever they told you in the past, it was impulsive. Okay, something that had been on their mind, but very impulsive. Now, let's tell me more. Oh, okay, hold on. So the Sun was here. So could have been about a child, thinking about having a child. For some, this person might have had some depression and thinking about times when they felt happy and joyous, or going back in and thinking, you know, it's spiritual illumination again, because the Sun does represent having, you know, success, right? I feel like this person was thinking about how to have some kind of success with you. Okay. And it was on their mind. It was weighing on them heavily. And I feel like they wanted to express that to you, and they came to you in the past, but they came like very impulsively. Okay. Here's the World, the Page of Swords. They wanted to have a big change with you. They might have communicated, you know? completing something in their life and, you know, moving forward into the next phase of development with you. And the world can sometimes be about internet communication or texting or, you know, digital type communication. So this might have been something that happened, you know, communicated through those means. Or it was just in person, or there was communication about, hey, I'm making a change and I want to have a lifestyle change and I want it with you of some sort. But I don't see love here. I don't see emotion. So tell me about the Knight of Swords. Now we have the emotion, the Eight of Cups. This person came in and then they kind of just pulled that Eight of Cups energy. Withdrawal. They pulled away, retreated. I feel like it was temporary because I feel like you may have communicated it another time after. But the main energy for them was withdrawal. And the main energy for them coming towards you was because there was withdrawal prior to that. Okay, so this person maybe felt like they went on some kind of journey and they wanted to share something with you, and they came into your life to tell you about some kind of change they wanted to make in their life, and they woke up to something, they've been thinking about it for a long time. And the Eight of Cups is kind of like, I want to come in and give you all this information. They pushed it on you. Because the Knight of Swords is a very fast-talking person. Like, I'm going to change my life. And then they kind of just pulled away. So the present energy is temperance here. Divine timing, balance. Can be about chemistry. But what's at the center of the reading is like complete rest, retreat. That's right now. No communication, solitude. Okay, this person is getting with temperance here. It feels like they are kind of coming into this place of like thinking about their life, taking things slowly in moderation, balancing things out. I do feel like it has something to do with you, because you see how that angel there has those two cups? Those two cups, you know, I feel like your person is like, okay, why did we come together? They're thinking about the romantic partnership or proposal or marriage. Is it the right time? Should I have done it? Should I do it? What do I do? Why did things happen the way they did? Why is there a lack of communication right now? Or should I wait to communicate or say something? This person's just basically hitting rock bottom here with themselves. Okay. And it's, you know, divinely guided is how I feel. They're like kind of like trying to find a way to balance their emotions with what's real in their life. Practical things, you know, because the angel has one foot. This can be all about the Trinity, but the angel has one foot on the ground here, and that's kind of like stability, and then one foot in the emotions, and that's about the feelings. Okay, so let's get a clarifying card for temperance. Okay, yeah, Two of Wands. This person's waiting for some kind of result. Sometimes I look at the temperance and I feel like mixing up the chemicals. Chemistry, I feel chemistry here. I'm waiting for some kind of test results, blending some things together. And with the Two of Wands, that's definitely can't make a decision or a choice yet until results have come in. And it could be about travel plans for some. There's patience and waiting. That's what the Four of Swords is right here. Take a look, this Four of Swords. Okay, this person's waiting to have a win, some kind of a win for something. Six of Wands, waiting for good news. Patiently waiting, not saying anything, not doing anything, waiting for some kind of good news. maybe to hear from you, or maybe the right time to communicate. Waiting for some test results to come back with Temperance, mixing some fluids together of some sort. But why is the Ten of Swords here? Because that's like hitting rock bottom. It's like a complete and painful ending of some sort. What does that mean? The Chariot. You know, I kind of feel like there's some bad news that comes to this person. It's painful. And with the Chariot, they're starting over something in their life, like making some big changes, or they get some news that changes the course of their life, but it's negative news, it's bad news. Let's get another card for the Chariot. Can you tell us? Tell Virgo about this Chariot. Okay, Page of Cups. Wow. Could have something to do with a child. It could have something to do with like love, communication. Okay, for some, if they're waiting for some kind of like test results, they get that result back, that cup. But I don't feel like it's very positive news. Usually the Page of Cups can be a very positive card, and I feel like it's mostly based in the delivery of a message. And I'm kind of hearing like the news is defeating. It's not horrible, it's not completely hopeless, but it's defeating. Okay, that comes in for this person. But it's delivered in a positive way, in a loving, gentle way, is how I feel. So let's see what the future is going forward. Okay, death. Okay, massive transformation and change happening to this person. Big change. This person's moving on, but there's a rebirth here for them. What does that mean? That's Scorpio energy there. We have Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Taurus, Aquarius, Virgo. All right, let's take a look here. What can you tell us? Oh, and Cancer. What can you tell us about the Death card? This person gets some hard truth. Now, if you are operating with the Queen of Swords energy, you could be giving this person some truth about something that puts an end to something. I don't know that the Queen of Swords usually comes through with hope, but I do feel, unless she's up in that Aquarian energy where the Star card would represent hope and new beginnings, but with the Queen of Swords, she usually is someone, you know, I don't see you coming in as like cold or rigid. I feel like you come in very kind, perhaps to help this person deal with a painful ending and a moving on, or death to a dream or to plans. I don't know. I don't really feel like, you know, there's much in the way of like this being about a romantic relationship, and I feel like your person is going through something pretty tough, and I feel like you're coming through as a very supportive energy. Okay, but this is also them getting clarity and truth about themselves, and perhaps this news that they receive. They could also have already received the news and just have not spoken to you about it, and they may be communicating with you about something that they were waiting to find out. Okay, and this is in the future. So the Queen of Wands is here. So this person, you know, they still have their confidence about them. They go through something, they gain their confidence back, Okay, the Three of Cups. Yep, because of a circle of support and friendship and people who, you know, care about them, they get back in the swing of things, I feel, perhaps. I don't see this person like going out partying or anything, but I just feel like they have a lot of support around them. But then the Eight of Swords is here with them. So the Eight of Swords, there is an energy of restriction, isolation, imprisonment. Let's get a clarifier. Sorry for the loud noise. Oh, yeah, I gotta tell you, you know, even though they have this support and they have their fiery, passionate energy about them, and they do manage to, like, I feel like this person, with the Three of Cups there, with the Queen of Wands, I feel like male or female, they come forward with like, yeah, I'm fine. They do have their support, but they don't want anyone to know that they're broken by whatever this news is that comes in. They feel restricted, they feel defeated. And I feel like they just have to go through this thing. You know, I do feel like you give them some kind of support. You help them with something. You may already be with them, maybe not, or maybe just a friend, but I feel like you try to give your honest kindness that you can. But what this person is dealing with, because the Ten of Swords has come back again, it's really had an effect on their self-esteem. And they kind of are placing themselves, like they're self-imposing their own prison. And I feel like it might be more of like protection. I feel like this news that they got has placed them here. But there's, you know, now they have to, like, they get the news and that defeats them. But now their self-esteem is defeating them. But it's also them coming to terms with accepting that they could not have what they wanted or what they were hoping for. They might have already known that this was going to happen, that something was going to, you know, come crashing down for them. But after the Ten of Swords, there's hope. There's light out there on the horizon in the distance. And I feel like this person just kind of like pulls away in a lot of ways, like restricts themselves from other people if they can. They spend a lot of time on their own, and they're licking and nursing their wounds. Going forward, they will be. Okay, but the Six of Cups is here. And a lot of this has to do with children. I don't know why. Past memories of children, because this is childhood. Could be childhood memories, thinking about themselves as a child. How there was so much hope when they were younger. This person could be receiving gifts. Maybe you send them a gift or something. But they kind of don't want to receive anything right now. But I do feel that once they come out of this dark place, and once they fully accept that that something was not meant to be for them, they get back again in their happy place, you know, and I feel like they do try to have reunion or reconciliation with you, but it's like innocent, it's sincere, could even be an apology for something. They had unrealistic expectations. They might tell you they were naive and they were just totally sorry for something. Okay. I don't know if it's something that you both, you understand this, or this is resonating as something you both are going through together, or just you're separated and this is something that you find out going forward with them, that they come clean about, or they tell you. Okay, let's get a couple of angel wisdom cards to see what your messages are here. Sorry for the banging sound. Okay. Seven of Pentacles, seeds well planted, efforts or investments that will be rewarded in the future, the need for patience, a time for resting and planning for the future, unnecessary worry. I feel like that had something to do with your person, but there were these seeds with good intention and good plans and efforts and wanting to invest. But I feel like some news came. I feel like those flowers didn't bloom in some area in their life, or couldn't bloom. What else? Okay, the Hermit. Time spent in peaceful meditation and meaningful solitude. Shine your light as an example to others. Seek out or become a spiritual mentor. Self-discovery. Well, that's you, Virgo. And you're being called here. Shine your light as an example to other people, Virgo. I feel like that's what this is. You shining your light on someone and giving support. And I feel like that is you also, in that energy of giving support to this person. Okay. Oh, strength is here again. I think you got that yesterday. Personal power and assertiveness portrayed with kindness, compassion that brings about forgiveness, realizing that you're stronger than you knew. You might be giving your strength and power to somebody else to help them through a difficult time. But it's also with compassion and kindness, and you're giving that. I feel there's a sense of release that now you are able to give that to yourself. Maybe you weren't before. But because of this thing that happens, I do feel like you're able to attain this now within yourself. It's very strange. Yeah, let me get another card here for you. Just feel like pulling another. These cards are so big and bulky. Okay, Queen of Cups. Loving, compassionate, psychic, self-sacrificing, deep psychic insights, caring for others, don't forget to care for yourself, trust your intuition, a deep love of family and friends, follow your heart. Wow, there's a lot of healing happening here between you and this person. Okay, and they've got the Four of Cups. Failing to recognize a magical opportunity, missing the point, distractions of daily life, discontentment or boredom, lost in your own world, needing to wake up. This person is just definitely going through this sense, you know, of hopelessness, becoming emotionally unavailable, like numb. That's like a numbness, apathy, feeling unfulfilled. You know, there could be gifts. People try to give them gifts, as like I said, and they just are just kind of numb. It just feels like, I mean, I don't really have advice here for you, but it feels like you're going to give your support and love and care. This doesn't have to be romantic. This could be a friend, you know, but whatever it is, it's just for the next 24 hours and then the future going forward here. So I'm going to leave your reading there for you, Virgo. I hope that you enjoyed this reading. I do hope that you will hit the like button on the video. That would help me very much. And if you would subscribe, I would be so appreciative of that. And also, personal reading links are in the description box below. All right, Virgo, take care. Love you. Bye.